So this is what our ancestors fought for, huh? This is what our ancestors died for? This is what the civil rights generation was all about. Being in relationships with Caucasian people, doing love scenes in movies with Caucasian men and women, taking off your clothes every single goddamn chance you get for a Caucasian man, letting white men touch your legs every fucking minute, getting their fantasies off on you. Disgusting. This is what the civil rights generation fought for. They didn't fight for, you know, equal rights. They didn't fight for black people, really. They fought for this. They fought for, I can't even look at this. They fought for this. The black women out there that had no problem going at the white men and always had an inkling to be with them, they finally got their shot on screen to kiss these men all the time. This is what the civil rights generation really fought for the love of these people that hate them and that still hate them to this day. They love this. They enjoyed doing this. They enjoyed showing this on screen. This is disgusting. Apparently, there were people that actually thought that that was actually ending racism because you're showing sex scenes or love scenes with white people now between whites and blacks. It wasn't doing anything. I don't know about other black men and black women, but me seeing a black woman kiss a white man on screen or making love to him does nothing for me. Me seeing a black man kissing a white woman in one of these old movies from back in the late 60s or the early 70s, you know, it does nothing for me as a black man. I'm not seeing my people represented in love. I'm seeing this unnatural love that is taking place on camera. And I don't like it. And as I've told you people before, because I know there are going to be people out here that just have a horrible fucking, you know, how should I say this? They got a horrible nature of believing that I'm racist because of what I say, which I'm not. I don't care. I'm not. But it does nothing for black people to have this on screen. It does nothing. You're making a statement saying, oh, racism is over now because before black people and white people couldn't be together and now they can. And they can even kiss on screen on soap operas and television shows and movies. How the fuck is that helping black liberation? How is that stopping discrimination? That's not stopping discrimination because there have been white men that have had sex with black women before. And they still hate black people altogether. They're getting something from her, so they just enjoy it, but they still hate. That's not changing their minds. You know what the craziest thing is about this whole situation? You could be the white supremacist and you don't change your mind when the black woman gives up her body for you, when the black man gives up his body to you. You still hate black people at the end of the day. But if a black person, you know where I'm going, but I'm gonna say it anyway. But if a black person has sex with one of these white supremacist people, you know, they may not even know this person is a white supremacist, but when the black person has sex with these Caucasian people, their whole mindset changes. You could be a black man that believes in black love and be the most intellectual black man on this planet. And, well, I'm going to rephrase that because you can't be that intellectual if you're getting in bed with a white woman and you're black. But if you are one of these diehard pro-black men who actually do mean what you say and you love your people, but then you somehow find yourself getting mixed up with a white woman and you sleep with her, your whole mindset will change. The black woman, the same thing goes for her. Sometimes the black woman's mindset changes before she even gets into a relationship with the white man because she has to read books on how to act prim and proper when she wants to get that type of man. But she can act ratchet and absolutely fucking foolish when she's with a black man. And that's not all black women. I'm not putting all black women down. I would never do that. I love my black women. But there are some out there that take instructions from a book on how to attract these men. They take instructions from Kristen and Karazin and the dumbass swirling camp that is still failing to this day, whether they like it or not. You know, they take these fucking instructions that are not getting them anywhere but to look like nothing but a slut. And it's sad. I don't like black women looking like sluts. I really don't. Because I know they're better black women than that. And there really are better black women than that. And I don't like these bed bugs getting in bed with these non-black women and thinking that they're getting a trophy, because you're not getting anything but more racism thrown at you front and center. You're in the thick of it now. You know, and these black people don't want to listen and understand that. And then you look at movies like this back in the day,
You know, some of those movies, most of those movies took place in the early 70s, but there are some throughout the 70s that have black women doing that, okay? You got black men who are having sex, like I said before, with white women, then they're having sex with their main squeeze, which is the black woman. That's nothing to celebrate as a black man when I'm watching a blaxploitation movie. I mean, some of these blaxploitation movies, you know, they did this. Not all, but there are some, and that's another aspect I should have added to the other video that I did that I didn't like. I didn't like when I seen black men having sex with a white woman, then all of a sudden they get in bed with a black woman who's their main girlfriend. I don't like that. That's not a good message, you know? And that's why, you know, I do my research on people, and that's why, like I've told you guys before, you're getting sick of hearing it, but that's why Pam Grier is one of my favorite actresses from back then, not only because she's beautiful, but because you didn't see her in any movie like this where she's having sex with a white man on camera. I mean, you can say in the scene in Coffee, she did kiss that dude, like, for a little bit of a second because she was trying to get herself out of the situation. That white dude, Sid Haig, I believe, people thought he was black, but he's actually white. But she quickly took care of him and finished him because he thought he was getting something. He didn't get nothing. She was just trying to get away. So I give her credit for that because she could have easily been a James Bond girl and been that black woman that was in the James Bond movie. I've said this before. So that's why I give Pam Grier a lot of credit, because you got these other black actresses that will take their clothes off for a white man and have sex with him on camera, even though they're saying it's art, it's just a scene. If that was my black woman and she was an actress and she was doing a love scene with a white man, I don't think me and her would be together anymore. Well, I'm not even going to say I don't think. I know me and her wouldn't be together anymore, because I have a huge problem with that. I don't like these motherfuckers to begin with because they're hateful and racist, so I don't want to be nowhere near them. I damn sure don't want my woman being on camera kissing one. Hell fucking no. It's not gonna happen. So, when my whole point of this video, I'm not rambling on here, but this is what the civil rights era fought for. Now, don't get me wrong, there are some blacks out there, black women and black men, who really wanted change. The Black Panthers are a great example of those, and you see what happened to them. The government got on their ass and took them out. Not all of them, but they took out some really key members, okay? So, you're looking back in the past and you're like, why are things not, you know, not changing? Because things didn't change. The only thing that changed was that you were able to marry white people now. You were able to be on television shows, and we were able to have interracial sex and interracial love scenes with them on camera now. That's the only thing that changed. White men were happy about this shit because now you ain't got to rape them. You can actually marry them now and then rape them all night, okay? Black men were happy too, because there are black men out there that couldn't wait to get their hands on a white woman legally and don't get their ass killed. But you still get your ass killed. Don't matter. You know, we're free. We're supposed to be supposedly free now, and you still got black men that will get killed over shit like this. Okay? Black women get into relationships with these white men and get themselves murdered as well. You're not off the hook as well. Both sides are fucking crazy. That's all I can tell you. But this is the civil rights generation and what they really accomplished. They accomplished integration. They accomplished interracial sexual access. And that's about it. No kind of rights. Okay? Affirmative action. Give me a fucking break, please. Just give me a break. Give me a break. What I just showed you in those couple of clips, and I had to be very careful about how I showed it, because those are scenes that really get a little bit, you know, raunchy or a little bit risque, so to speak. That's what people back then, black people, wanted. That's why a lot of the ones now who are older, they don't have any kind of fight in them when it comes to racism, because they wanted to be around these people. They wanted to make love to a white man, to a white woman, to have biracial children. That was their whole goal to begin with. We're going to force you to be with us because we want to be with you that badly. They wanted those people to love them so bad that they got a law of integration implemented so they could be near these people 24/7, 365. And these people fucking hate them. And they still hate them to this day. Just heard that a 18-year-old kid got shot by police. Okay? The racism and the hatred is still continuing. And you still to this day got some psychopathic people in the black community that are following psychopathic black women and black men, telling them to forget about each other and be with the very people that are murdering them every day in the street. Not only black men, but black women and black children as well. You can't make this shit up, and you can't make this shit make sense. End of story. When I come on here, like I said, I make sense. I make you understand that this is wrong. And if the ones that I don't make you understand, you're lost already. Because there is no reason in this world that any black man or black woman should ever even have an attraction or an affinity to be with these people. These people have not cleaned up their act. They have not cleaned up their act. And if you think that you are safe when you're close to them, you better think again. I love you all. And that is all for today. Peace.